Freud Spire is an outreach initiative aiming to create public interest in psychoanalysis, especially among a younger audience. David Clinton of the Swedish Psychoanalytical Society first told us about this format. We found the idea very interesting, especially regarding its potential with young people. So we decided to try it in Rome. If it worked, it could be a model for all the Italian centers as well as foreign institutes. We chose the location, the scientific bookshop Assaggi, with a cafe on the premises, located in a lively neighborhood very near Rome University and around the corner from the Faculty of Psychology. We printed some flyers, and the bookshop sent an invitation to its mailing list. A press article was published in a national newspaper. As for the theme, the title we chose, An Escape from Reality, seemed very adequate right from the start. And 8 colleagues were to give an informal 20 to 30 minute talk once a month. Each lecture was related to the chosen theme of An Escape from Reality from a psychodynamic perspective. Then, more specifically, lectures covering escape via drugs, compulsive sex, virtual reality, eating disorders, alcohol, danger and accidents, and finally, aesthetic surgery. To our surprise, about 40 to 50 people turned up at each lecture, and, even more surprisingly, there were quite a lot of young people, university students, as well as high school students. Some of the audience attended several lectures, but there were also new faces at each lecture. Each short lecture was followed by an open discussion with the audience, lecture and discussion never taking more than 90 minutes. All speakers were required to follow guidelines developed by the American Psychoanalytic Association for public speaking about psychoanalysis. Use of simple and plain speech, no more than 3 psychoanalytic terms, such as masochism, narcissism, etc. Explanation of each psychoanalytic term, and presentation of psychoanalysis in a positive and down-to-earth way. Discussions were always very passionate and lively. A glass of wine and snacks were served before and after each lecture, encouraging a relaxed and pleasant atmosphere. Freud's Bar has been an exciting and successful outreach initiative. It has allowed us to generate interest in psychoanalysis among a large group of people, especially young adults. Looking at the figures, Freud's Bar has allowed us to come into contact with approximately 400 people. We hope to spread this initiative among other IPA societies, and we would happily help colleagues organize similar initiatives all over the world.